Ladies and gentlemen, welcome right away to Captain Toad Treasure Tracker. This is our brand new Let's Play here on the channel. And it just jumps straight in the second you load up the game, as you can see. So, Captain Toad, released, I believe, 2014? It was born from a little mini game inside of Mario 3D World. And, yes, haven't played Mario 3D World yet, but you'll get that eventually. I decided we were gonna play through this game because it actually won the poll that I had on, the last update video. Now, if you look at the poll now, I believe it is not in the lead, but at the time I had, like, ended it, I'm like, okay, this is when I'm gonna, pick a game. This game won, so you guys wanted to see Captain Toad? Here's Captain Toad, so let's get going. As you can see, we're following Toadette around. We can tilt the right stick to move, or the gamepad. The gamepad is a little awkward to use, so I'm probably not going to be doing that. But, yeah. We made it to our first power star. It's a Mario game. Of course there's stars. Let's grab it. Here we go. The secret is in the stars is our first chapter right here. And our first section of this chapter, I guess, is number one, Plucky Pass Beginnings. As you can see here, we got three collectibles to find and the star. So this is very much like your typical 2D or some even 3D Mario games where you got three hidden collectibles and the main collectible at the very end. It's just a little different because we're Toad. So let's jump on in here. And we'll explain a little more of this. Time for adventure indeed. It Toad! Okay, so, as you can see, we got these gems right here. That's gonna be our collectibles. And if we turn the camera around, you can see there's actually a way to get into this one. So we can grab it. The Toad Brigade is also up there. So, I don't know. I really wanted to do Captain Toad, and I've never actually finished this game. I've never even really played this game, to be honest, before. So, I'm glad to be bringing this to you guys, and considering we just did Galaxy 1 and Galaxy 2, and those featured the Toad Brigade, I think it's only fitting that we do this. We cannot get in there. I think it's only fitting we have another, Toad Brigade-based game, so, yeah. So, I plugged this turnip out of the ground using the A button. You can also use B, I believe. B is also the run ever so slightly faster button. There we go, we can do that to bring this up. Wait, what are you? You're a mushroom, okay. And you there, sir. Thank you for the gem. Okay, so that is the last gem. We actually don't want to grab that star yet because there's going to be some stuff over here. We have a shy guy, as you can see. Pluck this, take him out. Now this right here, you can see there's a golden mushroom down there that we're going to want to grab. First, pluck this out, we're going to get a pickaxe, and it's going to play the classic hammer theme from Donkey Kong, which is pretty cool, but you want to get down here real quick, break that open, and grab the golden mushroom right there. It gives you 50 coins. So, yeah, and I'm just going to go ahead and pluck these out, grab a couple more coins from those, and now that we grabbed literally everything in this level, I believe it's everything, we can make our way back up here and grab the Power Star. Now, to be honest, the Power Stars don't really do anything in this game. They're not required for anything. But as you can see, there you go, collected the gold mushroom is a little hidden objective that you can't see until you've beaten the level once. But what I was saying about Power Stars, there's no real reason for getting them. Toad just wants to collect them, so. Anyway, you can now play using Amiibo. Check out the button on the top right corner of the screen for more information. Have fun! Alright, I shall. Let's take a read. Touch a Toad amiibo to the thing on the Wii U gamepad to play hide and seek on course pages you've already cleared. Okay, I actually knew this, so let's go ahead and put the Toad amiibo on the gamepad, because I have the Toad amiibo. And that's gonna throw Pixel Toad into the level. As it said there, tap on him when we find him. We can, oh, Pixel Toad is hiding somewhere in the course and you have to find him. And that is this course, so that one actually tells us where he is. Tap on the gamepad to catch him and clear the course. You won't be able to keep coins and items collected during hide and seek. So, go ahead and turn the camera all the way around and angle it. That's not gonna work actually, so we're gonna have to actually go all the way over there. Okay, fine, I guess we could do that. And he's gonna be, of course, around the back over here. We can just go like this, tap on him on the gamepad, and there we go. You got Pixel Toad! Now, that isn't a requirement for 100%, I guess. I mean, maybe it is, because it gives you a little stamp right there. So, we are gonna be doing that in every single level. We're gonna do, of course, the main level, we're gonna get the Power Star, we're gonna get the 3 gems, do the hidden objective, and find Pixel Toad. So let's go into the second level, Walleye Tumble Temple. Yeah.
Time for adventure! Time for adventure!
You can guarantee the Toad voice is gonna come out in this. Alright, so we could not go over there. Okay. I just remembered something, actually. You know what? We're gonna exit the course real quick, and we're gonna jump back in here. I actually know what the hidden objective is for this one, and it is beat the level without collapsing the bridge. So as you saw there, if we walk across the bridge, it will collapse. So we're not gonna go ahead and do that. We're gonna drop on down. We're gonna do this our own way. We're gonna do this a little differently. We're not gonna take the bridge. So, that's a bad move. I don't know why I thought that was a good idea. Hold on. Let me just hit you with that, sir, so I can get past you. And now we're Tiny Toad, as you can see. He does actually have a powered down state, which it looks adorable. You gotta go around the back of this guy. There we go. And there we go. Made it back. Okay, and come on, come on, come on, Toad! Yeah! Alright, what is this gonna be? That's gonna be a mushroom, so we can actually power back up. Good. Okay. So that's gonna turn. I still got 2 gems left to find in here. Oh, that's a hidden area. What do we got down here? We got a gem. Okay, and that's the second one. Now, the reason I opted to do this game mostly blind is not that I fell. The reason I opted to do this game mostly blind is because it is a puzzle game, and I figured having a puzzle game be done blind to where I'm trying to figure out the puzzles is gonna be a lot better than me knowing the solutions to all of the puzzles. I figured that made more sense, ultimately. So, I've played the first few levels, the first like 5 or 6 levels of this game, but I've played nothing past that, so what you're seeing is pretty much all I've played. Well, no, sorry. The first episode or two, I will have played all of the levels, that's what I meant. But after that, unless we definitely can't complete the level because I'm stupid, we're not going to be using a guide or anything. It's going to be blind AF. So, yeah. Okay, I almost like choked a little bit then. That was gross. Okay, I got this. Get you out of the way. I'm going to grab you, and then we're going to just speed on past you and grab our Power Star. There we go. Doo-loo-loo-loo-loo.
Water!
Sweet. It's so good to be playing this game. I've been considering Captain Toad for a while, you know? It's a game I have been considering doing for a while. And, I say that for all of my games that I like to play, but you know what? It's Captain Toad. It came out 2 years ago. I wanted to do it, so we're doing it. And let's go ahead and tap our Toad amiibo. And let's go ahead and find the Pixel Toad. Now, of course, what I recommend is from the very beginning, you just go like this. You just adjust the camera all the way around and see if you can find him. Now, I believe he's... Oh, he's there! There he is! Okay! I was gonna say I think he's in the hidden area, but nope, he's right there. Okie dokie. That was considerably easy. Alright, so number 3, Touchstone Trouble. Now, this one... It's impossible to get the hidden objective and also get all of the gems, from what I recall. You'll see why in a little bit, but as you can see, on the gamepad we can touch these, and it's gonna adjust their height. So if we get on the pink one, we can move it over, well, the height of the blue one, and the direction, I guess, of the other one. So, do that. We're gonna grab a key, Let's just check real quick. There's nothing in there. There is not. Let's get on you. No, don't throw the key. I think I tapped on Toad on the gamepad and he threw the key. Okay, hold on. Move that over there. Wait, key, get back here. I'm gonna put the key in there. Okay, and that's gonna just, it's just a gem, nothing more. All right, up we go. We're gonna go ahead and go onto the blue one. Take the blue one up. And then I believe, how do we get down to you? Let's see. So that goes down. That'll move over. How do we get into that hole right there? Am I being a dum-dum? Is there an entrance somewhere else I'm not seeing? Oh, there's one right there. Give me a gem in there. That's actually the third one. So, let's see here. Why is this so difficult for me to figure out? Hold on. How do I do this? Oh, wait. I go in there. I am so stupid. Okay, yeah. Puzzle games, I don't play a whole bunch of them, so I may screw up a lot here, but we'll see. We shall most definitely see. But there we go. Got yet another power star. Yeah. And as you can see, cleared the course in 3 touches is how you get the hidden objective, which of course we couldn't do right there. So we're gonna go back in and we're gonna do this in just 3 touches. Now let's see here. I think this, I feel like this needs to go up first. No, move that over. Let's get around this side. Take this up. Was that a mistake? Did I do that wrong? Wait. Yeah, 3 touches, that's how you do it. And that should give us the hidden objective. So let me know in the comments what you think of this, if this game is gonna be a good fit for the channel, I guess, because it is technically a Mario game. And it's laid out in a similar way, so, you know, level by level, so we'll see. We'll see, but I'm interested in your guys' feedback for this. Alright, so as for Pixel Toad in this one, I remember him taking a while for me to find, except he's actually right down there. He is a little hidden dude, he's right over there. He took me forever to find when I first played that level, so, that's fun. Alright. Next up, we have Mushroom Mesa. Mesa? I think it's Mesa. Mesa? I don't freaking know. Hello, Shy Guys. Go ahead and grab some coins. Because we can. Let me in here. I'm gonna grab this gem real quick. Wait. Oh, I see. We gotta go the long way around. Got it. And I believe there's also something over that side. Is there? There is. There's coins and a mushroom. Okay, I'll take it. Look how scared Toad looks when he's running. It's dumb. Okay, let's get out of view. God. Camera, adjust. There we go. Get these coins too, because we can. Alright, I'm gonna use this. Take out a certain Shy Guy over there. I'm gonna grab this one too. Now, where do we get in there? So we can get in the bottom of that purple thing over there. To get that gem at the bottom. Could I aim correctly? You know what? I think the hidden objective for this one is defeat all the enemies, and I've screwed that up because I just did. Like, I hit all the buttons wrong. I used up all of the things. Wait. How do we... Oh, I just figured it out. Hold on. Do that. Take that up. Take that down. We can get in here. And then I believe... We send that down? This is so awkward. The camera keeps zooming out. There we go. That's how we get that gem. And then we can work our way back up onto here, take that down, and take it back up again, and grab our power star. And we're gonna be coming back in here to take out all the enemies, because I believe that's the hidden objective, and I kind of screwed that up, so... Yeah, fun times. Yeah, defeated all of the enemies, indeed. Now, the annoying thing is, you can't do the hidden objective and also do the hide and seek, so... Anyway, here's a quick tip. You can open the manual from the home menu. You may make some unexpected discoveries there. We're not gonna do that. We aren't looking at no manuals right now.
Time for adventure.
That was painful. All right, so we even have to take out this guy floating over here. Well, he doesn't float once he attacks, as you can see, but let's see what we can do here. So the shy guys, obviously, we can take out pretty easy by using these. Just gotta not miss like I did before. And I'm gonna try and keep as much ammo around here as I can. We can also get an overhead view, which is nice. Alright, this guy, I believe we can take out like this. Yeah, okay. Now this guy up here. Yeah, we can't use this one. We're gonna drop that turnip right there. We can get in this. Wait. I'm doing this wrong. There we go. And do that. Then send this one up. Okay. Grab this. I believe the other one is a one-up, so... You wanna hit him with that one. Yeah, that one's a one-up, so that was our last chance to hit him, and we got him. But now, if we get the power star again, that should give us the hidden objective. That'd be great. If we could get it. On our first slash second try. Yeah, okay. And now, of course, we're not quite done in here yet. We're going pixel toad hunting. He fell. Oh, that's adorable. I didn't know he could do that. Alright, so this one... Let me see. I think I actually know exactly where this one is. But I believe we actually are required to go over there because we can't see him. So we go down here. Get these coins out of the way. There he is, hidden right behind the coins. Yeah. Now, like I said, after a couple episodes, maybe even after like one or two episodes, that's a couple, what am I talking about? I won't know where all of these are. Because, yeah. Also, the chase to Pyro Puff Peak. Did we make it to the next chapter? We did. We made it to the next chapter. So I think with that, we are actually going to go ahead and end today's episode off here. I think what we'll do is we'll split these episodes up so that they're in chapters like this. So, of course, the first episode is The Secret is in the Stars. We took on those first four levels and made it to the chase to Pyro Puff Peak. So that is going to be next time. So... If you guys enjoyed this episode, this first episode of Captain Toad Treasure Tracker, also bonus. What? We have a bonus already? Here's an important announcement for you! Super Mario 3D World save data has been detected. That means you can explore the Sprixy Kingdom as Captain Toad. We're not gonna be doing that right now. I didn't know that was here, but bonus is gonna be saved, of course, for like the very end, so... Super Mario 3D World spoilers, but if you have a save game for 3D World, you get a little bonus right there, as you can see. So, that is gonna go ahead and do it. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of this episode, and if you're excited for the rest of this Let's Play, in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.